Okay, buddy. I was just trying to cheer us up, so go ahead. Put on some old sad bastard music, see if I care.
I don't want to hear old sad bastard music, Barry. I just want something I can ignore.
Here's the thing. I made that tape special for today. My special Monday morning tape for you. Special!
Well, it's fucking Monday afternoon. You should get out of bed earlier.
Come on, dude. Play it. Don't you want to hear what's next?
What's next?
Play it!
Say it.
Little Latin loopy loo.
Mitch Ryder and the Detroit Wheels?
No! The Righteous Brothers.
Well, never mind.
No, not never mind. You tell me right now what's wrong with the Righteous Brothers.
Nothing. I just prefer the other.
Bullshit!
How can it be bullshit to state a preference?
Since when did this store become a fascist regime?
Since you brought that bullshit tape in.
Oh, man, that's great. That's the fun thing about working in a record store. You get to play crappy pap you don't even want to listen to. I thought this tape was going to be a fucking conversation stimulator, man. I was going to ask you for your top five records to play on a Monday morning and all that.
You just had to fucking ruin it.
Well, we'll do it next Monday.
No! I want to do it now!
I can't fire them. I hired these guys for 3 days a week, and they just started showing up every day. That was 4 years ago.
Communion After Dark.
Never left. giant war, the dead end road. Where do we go from here? Your expectations so hard to meet. What is the deeper meaning? We're reaching out for a helping hand. Show us a way towards a higher ground. Illumination so hard to find. You're open up our mind.
Symbionten bis zum Ende eurer Zeit. deserves to be hated. Fuck every last one of them for what we've all been through. Fuck society.
Welcome back to another exciting episode of Communion After Dark. I'm DJ Tom, along here with Paradise, Winters, and special guest back in the studio, Mouse.
Mouse Hi. Is in the house.
The moose is loose in the hoose.
Glad to be back.
This is loose.
Oh, no, you're not. All right. You just heard a band called Antibody from Germany, and the song is called F Society. Which I'm sure means fuck society. And that's the XRX remix. And that's from the self-band titled EP, F Society. And you can get that from our pals out of Dark Tunes Music Group. Part of that, we have a brand new Orphs from Canada. I'm excited about this release. They finally got something new out. The song is called Man of Sorrows. And that's from their new EP called The Way Through All Things. On Sonic Groove Records and Bandcamp.
All right, and then the fifth track in Gold Set was by Reaper, featuring Disastrous out of Germany. And that was the song, Der Tanzen der Dischnachte. The Distorted Signal remix. So I'm going to guess that's Destroyed.
Nope, Distorted Signal is Torben Schmidt's new... electronic project that he's doing with another gentleman that I can't remember.
Distorted. But is that Distorted without the vowels?
Yep.
Distorted Signal.
Distorted. Right.
Well, mm-hmm. Torben, it's already hard to say.
Very true.
But this is a remix they did from the original version, and they really souped it up.
And the fourth track in Tom's set was Blut Richter. Is that Rector or Richter? I've been reading
Reactor.
It.
Reactor.
Reactor.
We've been hearing about Rectors too much lately.
All right, Blut Reactor. And that's Destroyer of Worlds on the album Firestarter. And that is on Black Hole Society Records.
I'm a Firestarter.
I literally was reading this and I'm like, Blut Rector? Destroyer of Worlds, Black Hole.
And you thought we were bad. Oh, my. That's best. The third track in Gold Set was by Rune Conflict out of Ohio, or here in the United States. And Rune Conflict has a brand new, I believe it's an EP, out. The new track that you heard is called Get In the Epicenter. And that is on their brand new release again called The Experiment, which is on Infactor Recordings as well. So pick that up. Always good to hear from Rune Conflict. They always put out fantastic music.
There's only 100 CDs of this if you want the physical.
Those are probably gone already, huh?
Possibly.
Well, yeah, maybe. That's not a lot. I mean, that's like only a handful.
Nope. Xavier bought them all himself already.
Yeah, yeah, stop. Hey. All right.
All right, and then the second track we heard is an exclusive brand new vegan track. He's back. He's also the keyboard player for Toy. But he's got a new song called Pied Pipers. And this is a Rob Dust remix from a new digital single. I think it's a full EP. It's not out yet, but it might be by the time you hear it. So go check out his Bandcamp.
Isn't it like an old song from the 60s? It's like the Pied Piper.
No, it's not. It might be. No,
kids,
it's not.
Kid's story or something.
Yeah. So then we started off with an exclusive brand new track from Distorted Reality. They're back after 9 million years of silence. Recently, they did a vocal track on the latest Solitaire Experiments bonus disc with all female vocals doing the hits on it. But they're back, and they have a new single out called I Can't Imagine, and it's a digital single out on Bandcamp.
Nice.
Well, it's an exclusive world premiere, thanks to the band.
Oh, well, that was nice of them to send that to you.
Anytime special, guys.
I was thinking, I was getting them confused with that band that used to be on, what was it? They were like a harsh. No, not Dakota Feedback, but they had that song. They were like on Neutek. Oh, never mind. Doesn't matter. I'll never remember the name of the band, and so it's all going to go off into the ether. All right, let's go ahead and get our shot of the week in honor of Mouse coming back.
Oh, nice. All right, yeah. Let me get a shot.
All right, it's shot of the week time here on Community After Dark.
That is not a shot. That is like a tiny bottle of Cuervo.
Cuervo.
What's a Cuervo?
Where's yours, Winters? You have
I've
one?
I've got a fancy little glass I didn't even know that we owned.
Right. I actually poured too much because I thought this was vodka. This is tequila, okay. Right?
Yeah, it's tequila.
Yeah, that's tequila. So be careful.
No. Oh, no.
All right, ready? Let's do it. Shot of the week time.
Cheers.
Cheers to everybody. Cheers. Cheers.
Now drink your drink.
Ooh. Yummy, yummy, yummy.
Made a margarita in my mouth.
Margarita in my mouth.
Yeah. Drew's got the sugar-free margarita.
Yeah, it's just lemonade.
Oh, okay.
Lemonade and tequila.
Mine was amaretto and Malibu rum. It was tasty. I mixed it together.
Mine was Chambord.
All right, you did something different. All right.
I think mine was lemon. It was like lemon infused vodka.
That's what I should have had.
I love it.
Winter's, it was cold, so it was good.
Different.
Is Chambord right. The one that comes in the round?
It is. Thing? It is. Yeah.
And it's like
we got it for the CAD shot. The Chambord was the C, and so I still have it down there. So I did a shot of that.
All right. So. Now we're going to go to Winter Set in a second. Just going to do a few quick announcements, and then we'll go Winter Set. We got a concert coming up this Friday. If you live in the Tampa, St. Petersburg, Orlando, Fort Myers. No, not Fort Myers. It's kind of far away. But if you live in Fort Myers and you want to travel, come on. Harsh Symmetry is going to be here. Yeah, why not? Come to Tampa. Spend your weekend here. Harsh Symmetry will be here on Friday with Haunt Me. And this is the only show that they are playing together. Haunt Me is from Texas. They're both on tour. They just met up a little bit here in Tampa to play one show together. Orchard Tosca is going to open for them. He's an electronic wizard from St. Petersburg. And then Sunday, he'll be back out doing double duty at New World, because the first show is at Crowbar. So Friday's show is at Crowbar in Ybor City, which means once the show ends, you can go over to the castle and party as well. So you have a lot of partying going on Friday. And Winters is DJing that show. Sunday, DJ Cherry will be DJing, and we have Spike Helis. I don't know how you want to say that. Helis, thank you.
Yeah.
With Mother Juno and Orchard Tosca, also playing again. Lots of electronic music on Sunday. The show on Friday, if you're into new wave, 80s, post-punk, dark wave, that's a show for you. Sunday's show is a large amount of electronics, so if you're an electronics fan, you won't be disappointed with Sunday's show. Mother Juno is a very fun Orlando act. If you have not seen him before, he is crazy on stage. So he's definitely worth seeing. He opened for Front 242, I believe, last year. And his show was pretty awesome to see. And Spike Helis is crazy, too. They're a great
Spike,
band.
Yeah. Spike Helis
I'm wondering
like that.
If Nick of Orchard Tosca is going to do a different set for Harsh Symmetry, because he does do a lot of like kind of synth poppy type stuff, and I'm wondering if he's going to do more of that and then more of his like industrial like his new album War that came out for Spike Helis.
Maybe, I don't know, that's a good question, but those are who knows, we'll find out. So come out and support the shows if you can. We really would appreciate it. Live music, the only way it succeeds is if people are there to see the shows. That's the only way, people. It's just the truth. All right, Winters is next with whatever she wants to play.
Playing music.
This is Community After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Winters.
can't see silence, so scream to be visible. So scream to be visible. So scream to be visible. And the truth sets you free. I used to think that I knew. I believe that you do as you will. I once believed that's the truth. I believe that the truth sets you free. I used to think that I knew. I believe that you do as you will. I once believed that's the truth. Explores. Flex more, jack horse. Kids know, kids will hex wars. Flex more, jack horse. Kids know, kids know. You can't see silence, so scream to be visible. I now believe that perception is king. I felt the power of lies. I now believe that the word makes the world, and now the word will be mine. I now believe that perception is king. I felt the power of lies. I now believe that the word makes the world, and now the word will be mine. Hex wars, flex more, jack wars. Get you out, get you hex wars.
Kids, you're a hexer. of time, the wound of the signs, the end of me, side by side with my fear in the mirror. You really someone else, someone fills my sense, a stranger. When I face my face into the mirror.
To Communion After Dark. This is Winters. You just heard my set. That last song that you heard is brand new. This Eternal Decay out of Italy. And this is a single that's called The Heart of a Lover. And this is out on, I think they're still with Tristle Music Group. I think.
Treasel.
Don't quote me on that. Treasel. And you can get that on Bandcamp. It's a single. And before that, I played Ring Finger out of Canada, and this is the song Chamber of Roses that actually came out in 2022, but this is a remix by Joey Chaos. This is a single that you can pick up, and I am loving what was done with this song.
Ring Finger, lover.
That's what I was thinking. I wonder if they're named after a Nine Inch Nails song.
It sure sounds like it. Sure sounds like it.
The fifth track in Winter's set was by Non-Human. Spelled without any of the vowels. They're out of Germany, and that was the song Soldier of Beauty on their upcoming album called Circle of Doom. It comes out on May 25th, and it's self-released. You can pick it up on Bandcamp.
Right. Fourth track we heard in Winter's set was Orchard Truce from the U.S. And the song is called How do you say it real quick?
Orchard Truce. Orchard Task.
We should ask him at one of those shows.
I think Mike and I have asked Nick so many times, and I add a eh at the back, but then Mike calls it Orchard Task without me going, and then I say Orchard Task.
Yeah.
I make it all European.
Orchard Task. Okay. And the song is called Mock Stranger from the War EP, and that is self-released, and you can find that on Bandcamp.
Okay, and as we mentioned, he is the artist that will be playing here in Tampa coming up this Friday and Sunday. So pick up grab your tickets and come out and support. It'll be fun. Good time. He is very talented. I'm glad Winter's got him on the show here. The third track in Winter's set was by Replicant out of the U.S., The song you heard was No Cure. That's on the No Cure single as well. A lot of singles. And that is self-released. You can pick that up through Replicant's Bandcamp. And we have the link on our website, communionafterdark.com, if you want to check out these releases.
I know Replicant.
I know you do.
Yeah. Melissa and I found him years ago. Mm-hmm. And he had one amazing song that we couldn't stop listening to.
Oh, wow. Okay. Cool.
And the second song in my set is brand new with O'Donis O'Donis out of Canada. That's the song Beast, and it's featuring Tobacco. And that's on the album Icon that is going to be released June 9th, and that is on Felt Records. Is that Felt with an E? Is it Felt or is it
just? You don't have to Felt A.
Felt A.
just do it.
It's Felt.
It's Felt A. Felt.
And started everything off with brand new Faderhead out of Germany. And that was the song Hex Force. And that is on the album Ascender, The Ascender, that just released. And that is on Not a Robot.
Yeah, and when you guys played Noise Night, did you mention the music video and the downloadable graphic novel that you can get for free?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
We did? You know, I'm sorry. Yeah, we did.
Yeah, and then you can just even just download the comic if you're not interested in the music.
Yeah, you could go to YouTube.
Cool, though. It helps, yeah.
You can go to YouTube and click a link and download it.
Was Sam impressed with it?
I highly recommend if you don't follow Faderhead on Instagram, do so. Just do yourself a favor and follow him because he's a very interesting human.
Yeah.
And that was my set. I hope you liked it.
I hope you liked it too.
Winters.
Faderhead was really, I really like that new Faderhead. It's good.
Mm-hmm.
Very dancey anyways. It's one of those albums that'll get you moving around your house for sure. So go and go and give them some love. All right, and what are we doing next? Oh, Mouse is coming up next, and I just want to mention that we me and Mouse didn't do it this month, but since Mouse is here, we do a Twitch stream. It's on Twitch TV under Community After Dark. You can search us. We will be on there next month, though, in May. So come and check us out. I believe the next one will be May 5th. So if you want to check me and Mouse out playing some videos on Twitch, it'll be coming up May 5th. We usually do it once a month at the end of the month, however, but this month it didn't fall that way due to a few things. So whatever, regardless, come out and check us out May 5th. We would love to have you. Twitch TV, you know, I'm sure most of you are familiar with Twitch. If not, just download the app, search Community After Dark, and you'll find our channel. It's fairly simple. Join us on Fridays,
you can go
right?
online. It's a Friday, and you can go online to Twitch. You don't have to download anything.
Okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah. I mean, if you want it on your phone, which a lot of people do, but if you're afraid of downloading apps or you don't want to get into all that, you can just go on the browser and twitch.tv/CommunionAfterDark.
All right, cool. Well, there you go. So come and join us May 5th. All right, and Mouse is next. What are you starting off with?
I'm going to start out with Rain Reznor.
This is Community After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Mouse.
I love the way you're getting close to me.
Communion After Dark. Welcome back. That was my guest DJ set for the week. I hope you enjoyed that. All new music. So the last song you heard was New Zelenacht, which I know you guys have been playing on the show. Zelenacht is out of Germany, and this was the song Sakura on the album Lebensweg on Future Fame. And the sixth song in my set was new Aesthetisch, or Aesthetische. I don't know. And Machete. They're out of Brazil. That's how Fabio says it, Aesthetische. And the song was called Boiling Over. This was the Sebastian Komar remix. Earlier, you guys had played the Cesium mix. Or the first track. So this is the Sebastian Komar one.
Right, the Celsius mix, yeah.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Celsius, that's right. That's
mm-hmm.
right. And you can get this on Alpha Matrix. Tom, that's you reading number five.
Oh, sorry about that. All right. The fifth track we heard in the Mouse's set was by Neil Tears. In the U.S. and the song is called I Expire from their Crypt album, with a K, of course. And that comes out April 28th on Avant Records and Bandcamp.
So it could be like a crypt, or it could be short.
Crypt.
It could be a short crypt. Version for Kryptonite.
Crypt. Or part of Cryptus.
And the fourth track in Mouse's set is Rotoscope out of Germany. And that was a song, You and Me. That is the Rotterdam rework. And that is the You and Me single that you can get on Bandcamp.
Yeah. And
the third track in Mouse's set was by Horsk out of France. They are a harsh industrial noise act out of France. Good band. They have a new track out called Interface. And that you can pick up on their upcoming release called Body. That will not be out until September of this year.
Wow.
So... What? Keep an eye out for that. It's going to be on Wire Control.
Yeah. And there's a music video out for that track.
Hmm. I did see that, yes.
And the second song in my set was by Comfort Cure. They're out of the U.S. With the song Love in the Worst Way. And this is kind of like Darkwave EBM. And it's on the album called Not My Taste. You can get that on Bandcamp. And then the first track I played was by Rain Reznor, an electronic artist also out of the U.S. And this was her song called Alive, the remastered version. So it's a single, and you can get it on Ghost Work Records.
So I'm guessing this was a release that obviously Rain Reznor had put out before, and she remastered it.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. Thanks, Mouse. Good stuff.
Thank you.
And thank you for coming back. We really have missed you. For sure, because it's been since you were here on the anniversary show. So it's definitely been a little while since you were last on.
Yeah, it's been about a month.
Man, the anniversary show went by fast. It's actually been about 6 weeks, because the anniversary show was like the second week of March.
I know. We're only 2 weeks away from May.
That's crazy.
Like, this year is just...
Or 5 weeks, Mouse, I'm sorry.
Flying. Yeah. Flying, yeah.
Yeah, it's been crazy, man. Time's just going by. And then Mouse will be back next month, actually, as well. She'll be back towards the end of May, so don't forget about that. We're looking forward to having her back again. We will give you more dates as it gets a little closer. And... I did want to mention as well that we will be reading our donations and some comments in the upcoming sets. We thank everybody again who continues to donate to the show and comment. It helps us out very much. If you can do any of those, or if you have the ability to, we thank you. And it does make a big difference. We've talked about that in the past as well, about how much it helps and what it can go towards. We've been talking about that over the last couple of weeks. If not, we completely understand, but we truly appreciate all the people that have stuck with us. I know it doesn't, our show is not for everybody, and we already know some people who who don't listen to us because they once did for this reason or that reason. We got some message this week actually about some guy who didn't like us talking. We've been talking, unfortunately. We've been talking on this show for
since the beginning, basically
since we started.
Day one.
Yeah. So, we appreciate you listening, but you know, we try and make this a little different than just a normal music mix. So that's why we try and we also want to push the artists and actually mention them and discuss them a little bit. That's part of the reason why we talk on this show. And, if you don't like us, hey, we understand. We're not for everybody. Just like sardines aren't for everybody.
Sardines are great. They're for everybody.
They're for everybody?
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, why not?
Especially in mustard.
Go eat some sardines.
If you need to skip the talking, you can always listen to the show on YouTube, and you can just hit the timestamp.
Oh, but, there you go.
You know, and then just listen on YouTube.
There you go. Why not? Or go eat some sardines. One of the two. I don't know. All right. I'm next, and I'm going to be starting off with brand new IMX. So come back for that. We'll see you soon.
Communion After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Paradise.
If I can't do it my way.
right, welcome back to Community After Dark. It is the last set of our show. Fourth set. We've had extra music this week in the show for you. So we hope you've enjoyed it. The last track you heard was by, and I have one more song coming up, so don't go anywhere. I have a last track. But the track you just heard was by a band called ITCN out of Spain. And the song you heard was 1305 or 1305, 1305 BC Shadows. That is on their album called Survivor, and it's self-released. So go give them some love. They're more of a like EBM band, I guess, if you want to like label them. They have like an EBM sound to them. Pretty cool band.
The fifth track that Paradise played was Super Dragon Punch. With exclamation marks. They're out of Belgium, and that was the song Split, the SITD mix on the Split album, and that's self-released, but you can get it on Bandcamp.
And the fourth track in Paradise is set was Second Phase out of Germany, and that was Vox Array, and that is on the Utopium album that you can get on Dependent.
Yeah, we mentioned this before, but the album is not out yet. There is a few songs that have come out that you can pick up if you want to go order the album or just buy the tracks that have been released. I believe there's three total so far. So if you're a fan of Skinny Puppy sound or just dark electro with that Skinny Puppy vibe, Second Face does it better than anybody, in my opinion. I've heard in the recent, last 5-6 years easily. Good stuff, and they have great production on their music. And the album is coming out, but again, I don't have the exact date, so go to Bandcamp and look it up.
Right. Third track we heard in Paradise Set was by Red Cell, the band from Sweden, and the song is called Sleeping on the Mines. And that's from their self-titled album called Red Cell, and then self-released on Bandcamp.
Yeah, good stuff. If you like synth pop,
Red Cell, yeah, so good.
They yeah. are. Yeah, I mean, if you really, you have to like synth pop, obviously, because, well, they're from Sweden, so we know good synth pop comes out of Sweden. And yeah, good album, really good, like Mao said. The second track in my set was by 12 Illusions, which is a brand new band that had come out recently on Infactor Recordings. Their full-length album is now out, called Intruder. And the song I played was A Kind of Violence off that album. That's the name of the track. And they are they reside in Germany at this time. All right. And by the way, when we give the country names, which we do that just to let you know, I guess, where we're playing artists from. We just decided a while back that we wanted to do that. We're basically telling you where they reside now, not where they were born. Okay, we understand. Because we were told this week, which I understand, that B&B Nation is not from Germany. They're from Ireland. I'm aware. I am aware, I promise you. But we're just posting where they are currently residing. Yeah. We don't have the time to be going back and researching where every artist was born. I apologize, but we just don't have the ability to do that.
Yeah, Ronan's a Tampa OG, guys.
No, they used to be based out of Canada.
Who was? Ronan?
First it was Canada.
Really? He lived in Canada?
Yeah.
That I did not know. All right, we'll see. I learned something new. All right, and I start off a brand new IMX. IMX, again, is a fantastic artist, Chris Corner, who used to be in a band called Sneaker Pimps. If you're not familiar, go familiarize. Is that a word?
Familiarized.
Thank you, Mouse. yourself with the band. They have a new album coming out, but the single is out right now called The XID. And you can pick it up currently. It's available. So, yeah, good stuff. And by the way, big, big announcement, which we've already announced before, and I'm so excited. IMX is coming to Tampa. I'm thrilled about this. I mean, because honestly, it's a band that I love and I've pursued for quite many years to try and even figure out a way to get them to come to Florida. All right, so IMX is gonna be in Tampa on June 6th at the Orpheum. So grab your tickets before they are all gone. Yes, it's very, very exciting. They have IMX coming here. And yeah, there's my set. I hope you enjoyed it. Now we are going to read our donations for the week. And thank you again to everybody who continues to support our podcast. Me and Winters have talked about this last number of weeks about where a large amount of the funds go to. And we're actually going to try and one of these days make merchandise with the other funds.
Not me, guys. It's Paradise. You need to write him about it.
Well, I think we got it now because there's actually a place locally where we can have the merchandise made. Gold told me about it, and I believe Winters knows about it. So we're going to look into that and see if we can get some merch made for the podcast. And then if you're interested, let us know. But we got monthly donations from, and we did get 2 one-time donations as well. But let me go ahead and read our monthly donators. All right, we got monthly donations from Peter G, Aaron, Euro, and Aaron is, hey, Aaron, we haven't heard from you in a while. Send us a message. Aaron loves the hard industrial, I know, and we love Aaron. So thank you so much, Aaron. Matthew Nixon, Amy Black. Amy, come back, Amy. We haven't seen you in a while. We need to have Amy back on the show. Kalani Robinson, Christopher Starr, Evan Wajinga, Catherine. Hi, Catherine. Lance Cooley, Thomas of the Purge. Haven't heard any new Purge in a while. Thomas, you need to get some new music out there, buddy. We miss you. Adam Salmon, Kai Perigo. Kai donates on a weekly basis. Thank you so much, Kai. Biblio Dude, Andrew, yeah, for sure. Thank you very much. Andres Mirzik, Ross Martinez, Anders Shaw Natten, Pamela Jolino out of Alaska, James Trimarco, Jens Ara Munson, Jonathan Moser, and Rebecca from Australia. Thank you, Rebecca. And I haven't heard from Rebecca in a while. Hope you're doing well, Rebecca. I did want to also mention our 2 donations we got this week. These are one-time donations. You can go to communionafterdark.com. If you want to donate, and we have the option up there, you can do it monthly or as a one-time. In either way, we really, really appreciate it. We got one-time donations this week from Mona Membreno. Mona Membreno, who said, "Happy super belated anniversary, guys. The anniversary show was cute, and I enjoyed all the picks. Keep up the amazing work, and thank you for my weekly tunes." And thank you, Mona. Thank you for listening. Thank you for the comment about our anniversary show. We appreciate that. And we got a one-time donation from the Mold Doctor. Yes, Mold Doctor. I love that name. It said, "Add to your collection of scientists." So the Mold Doctor is from Minnesota, stuck in North Carolina. So I guess originally from Minnesota, now in North Carolina. Thank you so much. We love our scientists. We love them. I think that's what CAD's for. It's like for scientists. Like somehow our show resonates with scientists, which is pretty crazy considering none of us are scientists, not even close.
We all love Star Trek.
Well, that's true. That's
we love good, sci-fi that's a good point. Yeah.
That's pretty awesome, actually. So thank you again, though. Truthfully, I mean, I know, you know, it's not easy to, especially nowadays with the inflation and everything else that goes on in the world. We thank everybody who continues to stick with us. It's been over 15 years, and I know we have had a large amount of people who've donated to the show over the years, and it's been amazing. And I mean, if you don't donate anymore, but you were once, please, I hope you're still listening. And send us some comments. Tell us, hey, yeah, I'm still listening. We would love to hear from some of our old listeners, because I'm sure there's a few of you out there that still maybe listen, and we would love to, you know, talk to you or comment and chat with you. All right. And by the way, I suck because I know we've talked about this, but I haven't had a large amount of time, so I apologize. Before I go to my last song, I apologize. We have these giveaways. And Matt Hart was so cool to send us all this stuff. Bibliodude sent us a Baby Born Baton album. I promise you, next week we're going to announce the winners. I will find the time to make sure we announce the winners next week. I'm sorry again that I have not done that. I do have a new baby on the way. And I know people may not understand this, but when you have one child, and some of you do because you've got multiple kids maybe, but got one kid and then I have another one coming, and my wife, you know, is a little tired, which is understandable considering she's about to have another baby. I just haven't had the time, so I apologize. But I promise you we will pick the winners next week. I promise. All right. So I apologize again for that. My last track is going to be from the band that is coming up actually this Friday. I wanted to play a song from Harsh Symmetry, so maybe if you don't know them, you could check them out. And so this, I believe this track is going to be called Mirror Twin. That's the name
literally
of the track.
Literally one of my favorite Harsh Symmetry songs. So all the promoting that I've been doing, this song's playing in the background because I love it so much.
Good track. And again, if you're a fan of New Order, Joy Division,
Depeche Mode,
80s music, new wave, post-punk, this is a great concert in general for you.
And if you like really dark cold wave blended with post-punk, that's going to be Haunt Me. And it's very good, to the point where, hey, I was playing it in my car and my husband even liked it. And he likes techno, but it's just hard to describe. So just definitely come to the show. Just don't miss out on this show. We're lucky.
That's right. April 28th again, this coming Friday at Crowbar. So enjoy Harsh Symmetry and then come back for some comments.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Community After Dark. Thank you. That was my last song. I hope you enjoyed Heart of Symmetry. And now we're going to read some comments, and Mouse and Winters will handle that part for us nicely.
So we got a comment from the tall girl that tagged the Vogon Poetry track, saying it is a great song. It plays in my head again and again. Another comment from Lori Lindquist, who says, I greatly appreciate the timestamps. I'm always going, ooh, what's that song? And checking it in the timestamps. And wow, that first track by Niedemann was killer. Hope I can get them to play it at the club sometime.
Nice.
And then we got a comment from Thanos Tellis, who says, one more great show. Names such as Covenant, Wumpscut, Cassandra Complex, VNV. Thanks, guys and girls.
I'm glad to see somebody enjoyed that Cassandra Complex track I played. About it was Elvis. Good. Yeah, right?
Mm-hmm.
Hotline to Elvis.
All right, so all of these comments are from YouTube, because this is going to be a little bit of a longer show. So I just pulled them from YouTube. And thank you to everybody that commented on my set and everything. Just thank you. Harsh Electro, you can't go wrong. And this is from Lorcan Nagel. And it says, I was hanging up some laundry when winter set ended, and I'll admit I wasn't listening too closely when Paradise said, we need to lube you up. And my head shot up trying to figure out the context. Also, obligatory giving you a hard time for labeling VNV as a German band and not Irish. Well, all we learned today. All right. And then the next comment is from Jim Spear. Jim. And it says, excellent to hear Deadlight's new song. My girlfriend has Saul's signature tattooed after hearing them for the first time a few months ago.
Wow.
That is amazing.
That is amazing.
That's dedication.
I would like to see her see them live, like show off her tattoo.
Mustache Supremacist, which is like one of my favorite names. The guys of Covenant are great. They came all the way out here to Wisco to play at a small venue. When Dark Star started playing, everybody started dancing. Also, thanks for the shout out. Reminds me, I gotta tip the DJs. It's not much, but it's a token. Thank you, Mustache.
Mustache, it's my new favorite name.
Mustache Supremacist.
Yeah, interesting name there for sure. All right, Mouse, thank you so much for joining us again. Mouse, we'll be back.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, thank you. And we look forward to seeing you on Twitch on May 5th. And then Mouse will be back on the show towards the end of May. I believe Mouse will be on a couple of times because Gold's going to be taking off towards the end of May as well for Germany for a little while. So it'll be me, Mouse, and Winters kicking it for a couple of weeks. So that'll be a good time. Looking forward to that. All right. Yeah, it'll be fun. All right. So that's it for this week. I hope you've enjoyed the show. And again, make sure that you spread the word about the podcast and help us out here, people. We love you. Bye-bye.
Bye, everybody.
Yeah, it's about a guy who's blowing his pipes so he can get all the filthy rats to follow him.
Okay. Yeah, and then the townspeople didn't pay the Pied Piper, and he's like, all right, fine. And he left, and then he came back and took all of their kids, played a song, and all the children came out of the town and went into the mountain, and those children were never seen again.
It's a dark story.
Yeah, it's pretty dark.
Don't we all pay the Pied Piper after we have like 15 drinks?
It means pay your Pied Piper. Or he'll rob you of your
kids.
Yeah.
One of these shows we should do, remember that Gene, you should, like we should change our end music to Gene the Dancing Machine. Remember that when he was on the Gong Show and they would yank him off? That was hilarious, that dude.
If you send it to me, I can do it this time.
I bet you Gold could find it.
Gene the Dancing Machine? Yeah, he was on the show 9 million times.
Yeah, he was always on the. I think he was always on the show. He always came out and started dancing, and they would get off.
Was this something that happened in the 60s?
No, this is a show in the 70s. It's called The Gong Show.
The Gong Show? You remember The Gong Show?
I remember The Gong Show when I was really tiny. Didn't they have the giant cane, and they would, like, pull people off the stage? No, well, they did sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes, if they didn't leave after they got gonged.
Yeah.
Yeah, because when the celebrities have to get up, and sometimes they fight, like, who can gong the most because they can't stand them. But believe it or not, was it Oingo Boingo was on The Gong Show.
Mystic
Knights of the Oingo Boingo, and they didn't get gonged. And Danny Elfman was, like, in, like, a rock. He was walking around, and he had a rocket on his body with, like, smoke coming out. And he was pressing the smoke, and, like, it looked like he was farting on a dragon. There was a guy in a dragon suit.
This sounds ridiculous. Gosh.
But my favorite one that they gonged, that was probably one of the finish boss. was a guy who went out in his underwear and scrambled like a bunch of eggs, and then he poured them down his underwear, and then he just turned around and started like throwing a newspaper out of a basket, and then they gonged him before he could even finish.
What the fuck?
Well, I would hope so. What was he planning on doing with this?
I don't know, and I'm dying. I was in suspense. I go, why'd you gong him? You should have left to see how far he was gonna go.